Hello beauties, welcome back to my channel. This is your first time seeing my face. My name is Atunike. So I'll be sharing with you how I achieve this gorgeous bone straight wig using expression braiding hair. So this is a crochet hair, a DIY crochet hair. I'll be ventilating the front. So I've already shown you guys the hair we are going to be using from the beginning. Just picking the hair out so that the mouth will be like blunt straight, as in straight. Do you grab that? After picking it, I'm going to be using this airbrush to brush the hair through so that it will be smooth and it will be tangle free. Let me tell you, using a brush to brush it out, that does not give you 100% assurance that you've already detangled the hair. So I'll go in with a brush. I'll take a small section of hair, going with the brush. After that, I'm going to be using this comb to comb it out. You can see what is actually coming out from the hair. So if you want to DIY a crochet hair, you have to detangle the hair very well, because this is synthetic hair. So I section the hair on that rack. So after I'm done doing that, I'm going to be sewing down the lace. If you don't mind, you can actually make sure your lace is not big as mine, if you don't really want to take a lot of time, because it just wants to fake the front. No need of you ventilating a very big lace. Do you understand that? So after I'm done sewing that, I'm going to be cutting the excess net underneath the lace out. I'll be cutting it, we don't need that, so that the front is going to be flat and it's going to look beautiful. Any subscriber, thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back to watch my video. I really appreciate you so much, guys. Do not forget to turn on the notification bell so that you can be notified anytime I upload a new video. Now I'll start crocheting the hair. From the back, I use a small quantity, not really that small, but the front is going to be very smaller than the back, the amount I use at the back. So just crocheting, I'm knotting it once, not twice, once, because I want a very flat look. I'm going to be showing you the method I use in crocheting so that you won't crochet a lot of hair. You can see I'm using my hand to demonstrate where I'm going to be crocheting next, at the middle. And if you want to make sure you don't stress yourself when you want to detangle the hair, you can see that I raised the hair up for you to see the bond. If you can see that lemon bond I use in holding it, that is how I'm going to be holding all my hair, each track, so that I won't detangle it again. I'm going to be showing you how I'm going to do that. After when I finish crocheting small quantity of hair, I won't allow it to be too much, like a track or two track. Then I would entangle the hair together. I'll use a bond to hold it. You can see different kind of color of bone peeking through, because I said earlier I'm going to be holding the hair as I crochet, because I don't want to stress myself by me detangling the hair. That will be a lot of work. I don't want to do that, because you have to detangle it again. The more you section, the little amount of hair you want to use to crochet, the hair will get tangled itself back. So you have to detangle it again. So that is what you can see me doing. I'm detangling it again. After I'm done doing that, I'm going to be holding it down with a bond. Do not use a rubber band. You have to look for a bond that does not, that hair cannot stick to the body. I don't really know how to explain. So that is the bond I'm using. So we are moving to the top part now. I'll be crocheting a very little amount of hair at the top part, so that that plays with kind of flat and not obvious. I'm going to be doing the same thing after I finish crocheting the front part again. I will detangle it, then I'll hold it down with the band. I'm done with that. I'm going to be moving to the ventilating part. Yeah! So I'm going to be using a concealer to demarcate the air where I'm going to crochet to. I already ventilate some parts, showing you this part on camera. I didn't actually count how many pieces I'm ventilating. I just make sure I take a very little tiny amount of air to work with. Sometimes I make a mistake by grabbing like not really much, but it will be kind of obvious. I crochet it like that, then the next one I correct myself. I don't have time to ventilate one. I still want to challenge myself to do that, but not on this part. Just I took a little, very tiny, I didn't count it, very tiny, then I ventilate. You are going to see the vinyl look. It was not obvious. So if you are still watching to this part, thank you so much. You are the best. I really appreciate this so much. I enjoy doing this kind of video. I'm always happy doing something for you guys to see. Not even any outing, something meaningful, something you are going to see and you're going to say, wow, this looks so beautiful. Do you grab that? After I'm done ventilating the front part, I'm going to be combing it out. And I forgot to mention this, if you want to comb your hair each section, do not start from the top unless you are going to damage the wig cap. Start from the root, detangle from the root, then move to the middle, then move to the top. Can you see the final look? Can you see how the comb is just coming through? As in, nothing is even holding it. Can you see that? Can you see? So this is the leave-in conditioner I'm going to be using. I'll be hiding it inside the hot water. Hold on, let me explain this part to you. Please do not allow the hot water to be hot, as in overboiled, unless you are going to cook your hair. Just make it kind of not hot, not warm in between. Do you grab that? Because this water, I can actually dip my hand into it. You can see that it's not hot. So let me explain that to you so that you won't cook the hair. So after I'm done dipping it into the hot water, you have to brush it through. Do not leave it like that so that it won't get tangled. You have to brush it through. I'm going to be using this weave oil to add some shine to it. That is all. Just leave the hair to get dry itself. Do not use hand dryer to dry it. Allow the hair to get dry itself. So guys, this is the final look. The hair looks so soft, as in so light, so beautiful. Oh my god, the hair is 32 inches long. So thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to like, subscribe, comment, share with your loved one, turn on the notification bell so that you can be notified anytime I upload a new video. Thank you so much for watching. See you in my next video. Stay blessed. Ciao, love you.